Hey, sir, where you headed? I said, where you headed, sir?
Catch a shuttle.
Oh, yeah? Where to?
Waterfront Plaza.
Waterfront Plaza. I'll get you there half the time, $40 flat rate.
40?
All right, 30.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah? Hop in. Man, man. This traffic today is killing me.
Yeah?
Yeah. The whole airport's jammed up.
Yeah.
Waterfront Plaza is nice, though, huh?
Yeah.
It's a classy joint. Really? This guy's gonna stop right there. He's gonna unload the whole thing. Unbelievable. Unbelievable. I'm sorry about this.
It's okay.
Long flight?
Long wait. At the airport for 5 hours.
That's a bummer.
That's okay. I like airports. Great for people watching, you know?
Yeah. Yeah, I do know, actually. I'm always watching chicks around here. They got that juicy written on their ass. Pretty good.
Talking about a different kind of people watching.
Yeah, what do you mean?
Human behavior. The way people move. Speak. How they say goodbye. Girl kisses a guy at the terminal. She's in tears, but he's placid. She keeps looking back as he walks away, but he doesn't turn to look at her. Not once. You know, he doesn't plan on seeing her again. Ever.
Come on, man. You can't know that kind of stuff.
I'm waiting at the gate. It's a year after 9/11. Now, there's this guy wearing a turban, and everyone's staring at him because they think he's a terrorist. So he gets smart, pulls out a book. Harry Potter.
Oh, shit.
People relax. His logic worked. Terrorists? They don't read Harry Potter.
So he wasn't a terrorist?
No. They did catch a terrorist at the airport that day, and I had my eye on him from the very beginning.
Who was it?
The guy who said goodbye to the girl and never looked back.
Come on, that's a bullshit story. Is that a true story?
As true as the gospel.
Holy shit, that's a great story. Come on, every bag. You gotta move every bag. I'm Sammy, by the way.
Greg.
Good to meet you, Greg.
Good to meet you.
You didn't get any sleep, huh?
No. A couple next to me wouldn't stop yakking for 3 hours straight. I could have strangled them.
Yeah. Tell you what, I know what you're talking about. I get passengers in here all the time. They're on the cell phone, talking, private stuff. Stuff I shouldn't even be hearing about, you know what I mean? You got people coming in here with hookers and cocaine. I mean, I'm telling you. I've been doing this shit for 17 years, driving a cab. You see some crazy, crazy shit. Finally, thank God. Good, can I go now? Any day! Can you believe this? Like, you mean this the whole thing? Watch it! Ah! Shit!
Are you crazy? You didn't see her walking?
Sorry.
Are you okay?
Are you all right?
Jumped out of nowhere.
Just, I was walking. Blind?
Are you okay? Can you walk?
Let me take it
hurt.
No. What you need to do is give us your insurance information.
Yeah, I can't do that right now, okay?
What?
I'm in serious trouble if I give you insurance.
Why don't you just take the cab and I can get it?
No,
dude, it's your cab, man.
It's fine. Well, where are you guys going?
Waterfront Plaza.
For real?
Yeah.
Waterfront Plaza.
That's right around the corner from where we're going. Maybe you can just drop us at the hotel.
Could you guys give us a ride?
Let me take you to hospital.
You okay? Yeah, I mean, you should probably.
Are you sure? Yeah, if you could just drop us at the hotel.
Are you okay with that?
Yeah, sure.
Sure?
Yeah.
Okay. You sure okay?
Yeah.
Is it hurt? How's your leg?
I'll be fine.
You're lucky she didn't break nothing.
Ah, Jesus Christ, I'm so sorry about that. I'm sorry I can't file with the insurance. Just that I'm coming for my brother, and if his boss found out, then he'd sack him for sure or something.
Don't worry about it, man. I'm not gonna report you.
I'm Casper. You know, like the friendly ghost?
Friendly ghost, evil spirit.
This wise ass is Billy. Billy the Kid.
Greg.
I like your style, Greg. Nice.
I have my handbag?
Here's the key. Sharing the ride, I can pay cash if you pay credit.
Sure, it doesn't matter.
I just can't pay credit. Every time I travel out of state, my cards get declined. I think the bank thinks it's like fraud or something. Identity theft.
Nobody wants your freaking identity.
Well, you know, I heard on the radio that identity theft was actually up. You know, like big time, yeah.
Hope nobody stole my credit card information.
Nobody stole nothing, man. You're just maxed out. It's the fucking economy.
I don't want to blame the economy. The man is responsible for his own living. Nobody's gonna hand it to you.
That's true. Such thing as a free ride.
Now you said it. Hey, where are the best girls in town?
Girls?
Yeah, strip clubs. Billy boy here has never been to a strip club. I wanted to get some adult education.
Knock it off, man.
What? I think it's important to try everything at least once.
I did, and I don't wanna.
Yeah, well, a lap dance from a cellmate don't count. Thinking of, you know, like a classy joint, you know, like a nice entry-level strip club. You got any recommendations?
Boy, oh boy, there's some strip clubs in the area, but classy, I don't know about classy.
Hey, what about you? You a fan?
Fan?
Strip joints.
No. I'm institutionalized.
Institutionalized. I like it, that's good, that's good.
Institutionalized? Rich. Sounds like a prison sentence. Whoa, the fuck is that supposed to mean?
Well, your friend just said you got a lap dance in prison.
I didn't get a lap dance, and it was county jail. The whole thing was bogus.
That is nothing to be ashamed of. I think it's important to get a little roughed up by life, you know, get some perspective. It's my philosophy.
Your philosophy sucks. The cab kind of smells like those little cheap, you know, pine tree. Air freshener things.
Jesus Christ, awful, right? I keep telling Eddie, gotta get rid of that crap. Eddie's my brother. Yeah. That's who I'm covering for with the cab today.
Oh, that's Eddie.
Yeah. This is his cab. Usually I drive a sedan, and Eddie's getting laser eye surgery. Yeah. Finally. Gotta get in the cab with this guy's like a death wish. Anyway, I gotta switch out this ID though because I can get trouble from the cops doing that. Driving the cab's a racket. Some days I wake up, I wanna be in a new business, you know what I mean? Instead of being in this hot box all damn day, breaking my back.
Yeah, this guy's cool, but as a general rule, always make sure the cabbie is the same guy in the picture.
It's true. You gotta watch out for gypsy cabs.
Oh, some unregistered cabs do all kinds of shady stuff.
Oh my God, are you kidding me? I know some drivers that pick up a tourist, take him for a half an hour drive, when they gotta go four blocks.
Yeah.
Looking for like a little tour of the city.
Oh, better the tour of the city than the millionaire tour.
I don't know that.
Ever heard of the millionaire tour?
No.
Ooh.
It's bad.
Yeah?
Yeah, started down in Mexico, Puerto Rico, Brazil. They're doing that shit locally now, though.
Get to the juicy part.
Some guys hang out at the airport. They wait for a cab driver to pick up somebody that looks rich, somebody, like, loaded.
So they pull a gun on Richie Rich, and they take him and the cabbie for a ride.
They stop at every ATM on the way, make the guy withdraw cash from his credit cards, debit cards, everything until he gets declined.
Squeeze the life out of the poor bastard. No, this guy's got no mercy, but they got time.
You hear about this thing?
Yeah, I mean, I heard about things like that. I didn't know it was called the Millionaire Tour.
Millionaire Tour, yeah.
Huh. And it's here in town, you said?
Yeah.
In a city. Oh, that's crazy. I thought you guys were from out of town.
Yeah, we go back and forth for work.
You wouldn't have to travel so much if the economy weren't fucked.
Oh, what is it with you and the fucking economy? What did the economy ever do to you?
Nothing. That's the point right there.
I get that shit.
Yeah, you know, I'm just tired of being pushed around, working for the man. And if I had my own cash, I wouldn't even be here. I'd be my own boss. Like this guy.
This guy? What do you got against this guy? What do you ever do to you, huh?
Nothing. I just feel like I know him. Fancy suit, fancy watch. People got no respect for somebody that doesn't make a lot of money.
You have no idea who I am, and you talk too much.
Oh, yeah? So how much do you earn a year?
And your fucking business.
Oh, that fucking much, huh?
Come on, man. He said Waterfront Plaza.
You know what? Forget about the plaza. Get off here and drop me off.
What?
I'm getting out. Had enough.
Come on, man. We're just talking.
Ah, he wants to get out. Let him.
Am I getting off at this exit or
yes,
what?
Yes, right here.
All right.
Stepped into the wrong cab.
Yeah, you sure did. Hey, what are you doing now? What are you doing? Hands on the wheel.
Hey, take it easy.
Stop it, this guy.
What are you doing? What do you want from me?
want to get to know you a little bit better. Gregory J. Newman, 426 Pine Drive, Santa Rosa, California. Oof. Thank God you got rid of that mustache, dude.
It's a little presumptuous of you to give other people fashion advice, sexy. Oh, that's you? That's disgusting. She's right.
Take the money. If that's what you want, just take it.
Oh, thank you. That's very generous of you, man.
Yeah, everybody's generous with a gun in their face. Hey, hands on the wheel or brains on the windshield. Your call.
All right.
Quanto? Quanto?
Nada. $52.
That's it? It's barely enough for the ride. I guess we're gonna have to stop at an ATM.
Give me your cell phone. Give me your cell phone.
All right. Hurry up. It's not a fucking game.
Got his attention.
Thank you. Like I said, we need to make a cash withdrawal from your account.
Your account.
Why are you doing this?
We will get to the why. We have a long ride ahead. Now let's first focus on the how.
This is what we're going to do. We're going to go to an ATM, and you're going to withdraw the maximum amount from your credit cards and debit cards. $400 at most ATMs.
You've got my wallet. You've got my cards. Why do you need me?
It's a good question. This guy's smart.
Yeah. See, we don't want our faces to end up on Dateline when those little ATM cameras film us. We're not that photogenic.
Huh. Speak for yourself, sexy.
Are you done? Can we get started?
Patience, little sister. We didn't even tell Greg the most important part of the millionaire tour.
Which part?
The getting shot part.
Oh, yeah, that's the part that people always fuck up.
Okay, so Greg, listen, this is very, very important. You try to run, we shoot you. You try to make a scene, we shoot you. You fuck around, you do all kinds of brilliant things.
We will shoot you.
It goes for you, too. You take your hands off the steering wheel again, you unfasten your seatbelt, you open your door without permission, we will be scrubbing your blood off the dashboard, I promise you.
Got it.
You're not gonna call dispatch. No. Yeah, that's right.
Okay. I don't know where I'm going.
Okay, turn right, make a left. You're gonna pull up at the ATM around the corner. Are we clear on how this works?
What can I do to make you not do this?
That's a good one. It's nice. 4 ATM withdrawals, $1,600, not getting shot, priceless. If you have any doubt that I'll shoot you, Greg, just try to run. Take this exit.
Okay.
Stretch your legs. There's an ATM right there. Make it snappy, I'll be waiting right here. I like that. What are you getting, a statement? Go. Let's go. Put you in the back. Make it nice and cozy. Success. Okay, go.
Where am I going?
To the fucking end of the rainbow. Just drive. Quit being an asshole.
What's the long face for?
It's going from recession to depression.
I told you the economy is going to hell.
We're all going down.
1600.
We done?
Done? Barely even started.
Well, what are you gonna do when the cards hit their daily limit?
If I told you, that would ruin the surprise, wouldn't it?
Hey, man, what is that?
What? This?
Yeah.
Oh, this is, shit that Eddie's into. It's like a tarot card.
No, I know that, but, like, what does it mean, that one?
don't know what it means. It's a guy hanging upside down.
That doesn't make any sense. I mean, a guy hanging by his foot upside down. It's like, it's no way to die.
No way to die? What's a good way to die?
With a bang. Pow, pow. Get it over with.
Yeah, I think it's more like a symbol, you know, of death.
Oh, yeah, no, for sure.
Two morons. You have no idea what you're talking about.
A really wise guy. Enlighten us.
Okay, I will. It's not a symbol of death. It's a symbol of life. It's a journey. The guy's hanging upside down. All his possessions are falling out of his pockets. He has to rid himself of all his possessions. Only then can he be free, get clarity, see the light. You're welcome.
Some big words for a guy that didn't even graduate high school.
Yeah, well, I learned it from a fortune teller. She read me the cards.
A fortune teller?
A gypsy from the Bronx.
And she read your future?
Mm-hmm. Future ain't gonna read itself.
Okay, what did she say?
That is none of your business.
Come on, man. Don't be like that. What did she say?
Pull in there and park.
Yeah, right here.
Yes, right here. All right, here we go.
Why are we stopping here?
Going bowling.
Seriously.
Greg needs to practice his pins.
Okay, but this isn't...
Isn't what?
Can we talk?
We're talking.
No, outside.
Oh, my God. Thank you. Be good. What? Why are
you doing this? You gotta help me.
We said we don't do ATMs inside.
Oh, come on. This place is dead. We'll be over in 2 minutes.
It's too dangerous.
Two of us together, we can take them.
No, that's not gonna happen. I can't do that. I got a wife. I got a family.
Grow a pair of balls.
Grow a pair of brains. It's too risky. I don't want to do it.
You wanted in on my gig. You play by my rules. You want to be a man? Here's your initiation ceremony. Join the
fucking club. Look, don't be stupid. If they kill me, they'll kill you too. You're a witness.
Listen to me, okay?
Are you stupid or something? The Roman said bring him back ASAP. He probably doesn't even know we're giving him the millionaire tour.
The Roman doesn't need to know. The Roman pays shit, and I need to make a living. You shouldn't care if we squeeze some money out of this guy. He's a dead man anyway.
What? The Roman's gonna kill him?
I don't know.
Don't bullshit me, man.
What does it matter? You need the money. Just do your fucking job.
Just give them the money. Do whatever they ask. Don't be a hero. If we just do what they say, we might get out of here in one piece, okay?
Get out. Come on.
Hurry up.
All right, easy. We're in and we're out, and I'm talking to anybody. Here for the early bird special?
Hell no. Last time I had your chili, I got an STD.
Yeah, the chili is pretty nasty. The buffalo wings come with a minor rash, but you can have that on the side.
Maybe next time. What are you waiting for? Hurry up.
It's the client.
Try another course.
I'm a good judge of character. You can wave that gun around as much as you want. You're not like him.
Don't act like you know me, okay? You don't know me.
You gonna keep letting him boss you around like that? I'm serious. You don't have to take that from him.
Yeah, just shut up and hurry up, okay? Let's go.
What are you, stupid? Clean up this mess, or I'm gonna fire your ass.
Hey! Don't talk to her like that. It's rude and humiliating.
And who the fuck are you?
Stab you in the face, that's who the fuck I am. I don't have to take that shit. Fuck!
Thank you.
you're bluffing? Hey! Next time I shoot you in the face, get in the fucking car. Get in! God damn it!
Why did you shoot him? We have to get out of here.
I'm sorry. He stuck that gun to my head. I didn't have any choice, okay?
Think you're tough?
We have to get out of here now!
Think you're tough, you fucking coward? We should put you in a dress and send you to prom, Jenna.
Hey, don't call me that.
What are you gonna do? You can't use your gun? He gets away, the Roman drags us to hell.
I didn't want to shoot him. I thought the Roman wants him back alive.
So you let him run, you Barbie doll?
You know what? Fuck you. Let's just bring him back and get it over with.
We will bring him in when I feel like it. And don't let him fool you. That ain't no Greg from Santa Rosa. That's Julius Jax. He's hustled stronger, smarter people than the both of us. And before you know it, he'll take you on a ride, too. Get in the car. Damn it. Go. Washington West. Washington West! Do you want an itinerary?
Fuck.
Wow.
What the fuck?
What?
Where are the cards?
I threw them away.
What? Where?
The junkyard when I was running.
Shit, turn around.
Don't turn around. We're not gonna find him, you fucking Pollyanna. That's the last time I take you on a job.
Jesus Christ.
Shut up and drive. Give me that. You're an idiot. An idiot. God damn it. I can't believe this.
What, do you want me to write you a check?
Do I look stupid? Cash only. Cash is king. I'm gonna write yourself a check. Hey, do you have anything to clean with in here?
You talking to me?
Yes, taxi driver. I am talking to you. Do you have something to clean with?
I think so. Hold on.
Kleenex, a napkin, a serviette. Yep, yep, yep. You can wait. Clean your face. Clean up.
And when you are all fresh and clean, I'm gonna cash a check.
Give me account number on the check, so Greg doesn't need to employ his poor memory. This thing should work out perfectly.
So you need some water?
Yeah, thanks.
We can't.
What?
It's not safe.
You mean you can't? I can. And Greg for sure can. Greg, you wouldn't mind going to a local friendly supermarket.
Fuck you.
That's the spirit. Okay, make a left here and park.
You got a place where you can cash checks in the supermarket?
Mm-hmm. And $1.99 bucket of chicken wings. Ah, you look nice. Right here. Back in 5.
Yeah, try not to lose it.
I'm gonna say I'm your brother, okay?
You're gonna tell him your bank's closed, and write yourself a check for $5,000. You good?
Okay.
Don't say okay. I know what you're thinking. It's a supermarket. It's busy. Lots of people. A guard. You'll make a scene. I won't shoot you. Wrong.
If you try to burn me in any way, I'm gonna have to shoot my way out. I'm not bluffing. I'm not going back to prison. You get the first bullet, and our cabbie here gets the second one.
I'm going to shoot you. Let's go. Come on, pick up the pace.
Can't complain. You?
I can complain, but I probably shouldn't. What they say, honest living ain't much of a living. Come in more often, I got paid more often.
Yeah, I feel you.
Hi.
How you doing today? Rebecca.
You can call me Becky. I'm super. How about yourself?
Couldn't be better. I get to spend quality time with my brother from out of state.
Aww. Well, so how can I help you all today?
I wrote myself a check, and I need to cash it.
I love how he's always.
smell suspicious when he talks about money. Not even a smile. She's gonna think we're robbing the place. So, 5,000, that's the maximum amount that we can withdraw, right?
Yes, but we usually don't accept checks written to self.
Yeah, unfortunately, our bank is closed, and we're buying our mom a car for her birthday.
That is so sweet.
It was his idea, yeah, but the dealership said that we could get a 5% discount on the down payment if we pay cash.
Can I see some photo ID? Gotta love those cash discounts.
Great.
Yeah.
Oh, serial killer.
You two don't look much like brothers.
Yeah, well, he got the looks.
Well, that usually means you got the brains.
I've heard that before.
One moment, gentlemen.
Cheer up. It's only money.
You broke your own rule. They're on camera.
Don't get cute.
Okay, good. The account was verified. We can cash the check, and the 2% fee comes out to $100.
Ouch.
Yeah, can I just take it off the total sum?
Yeah. Sure.
Okay.
Yes, sir. Thanks. Mm-hmm.
$4,900.
Oh, it's okay. We can just put it all together. We have to get to the dealership.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Well, would you like me to give you an envelope?
Sure. Yeah, you never feel safe walking out with all that money, huh?
Yeah.
Okay. Well, thank you.
You're welcome.
Very much.
Is there anything else I can help you with?
No. Thanks a million, Becky.
Oh, and I almost forgot. Would you like to make a small donation to the Lifeline Foundation? Every dollar you give goes to help somebody with coronary heart disease.
Yeah.
The minimum amount is $5.
What's the maximum amount?
There is no maximum. You can donate however much you'd like.
Can I pay for it in cash?
Absolutely.
Okay.
Okay. 5, 6, okay. All right, all right.
$1,000.
There you go.
I am just totally... Wow.
Generous.
That is so great. Thank you so much.
You're welcome.
Okay. Thank you, Rebecca. Bye.
Wait a second. Sorry. I can't forget that. You're a good man, Greg. I hope that your kindness returns to you.
Thank you, Becky.
All right, we're out of here.
Have a wonderful evening.
Bye, Rebecca.
Becky.
Sorry, folks. Need to check your bag.
George, they just donated $1,000 to charity. $1,000.
Have a good day, folks.
Okay, bye.
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 Okay, let's go, fuckface. I would have paid for it, but I didn't have my credit card.
Oh. Yeah, easy does
it. All right, I think he gets the point.
Hey!
Casper! Woo! Enough!
Hey.
Enough!
Hey.
Here we go!
Hey! Sit down!
Wait, were you gonna shoot me? Shoot me! You think we don't know who you are, you son of a bitch? I got news for you. You've been for a long ride. You have a one-on-one with the Roman, Mr. Julius Jax. Now behave! Ah. What are you talking about? Who's Julius Jax?
You think my name is Julius? I'm not Julius. You made a mistake.
Yeah,
Wait a minute, I've never even heard of Julius. My name is Greg Newman.
Yeah, okay, and I'm Cinderella.
The Roman is waiting for you. Remember the Roman? Still a little pissed about the $4 million you stole from him.
I never stole anything.
Yeah, except for these.
We thought we'd take you on a little millionaire tour before he sticks you in the ground, but you had to get rid of the cards.
Yeah, to cut the tour short. Roman's looking forward to a little reunion.
Listen to me. You made a mistake. Right? You picked up the wrong guy. I don't know any Roman.
He saw you at the airport. He saw you get into this cab.
Then he made a mistake because I'm not him.
I thought you'd say that.
You did.
Yeah. You're good, Julius. Trust me, I met a lot of con men in my life. The stories I heard about you, you get a hook and a ticket check. Now, hey, listen to this. I knew this guy in prison, okay? He told me about how Julius carjacked, I correct myself, legally impounded, right? Legally impounded? Legally impounded a fucking Maybach.
Unbelievable.
Drove home in a $500,000 car, that's Julius. He can pass as anything that he wants, that's how good he is. If he pretended to be a fire hydrant, dogs would piss on him.
I am telling you, you got the wrong guy.
This whole journey would be a lot easier if you just fessed up. We could reminisce about the Roman, how you stole $4 million from him.
I don't know where I'm going. Am I taking a five?
No, stick to the 210. Right. I will tell you where to get off.
Do you have any proof that I am
here? Oh, Jesus.
You want proof that you're Julius?
Don't waste your time on him. He's lying through his pearly whites.
He's entertaining.
You want to talk to him?
Talk to who?
Your wife. We forgot to mention that we got her. Just slip my mind.
Yeah, the Roman's keeping her for insurance.
Show's over.
You can stop acting now.
I don't have a wife.
Oh, my God. Here we go again.
This guy is unbelievable.
He won't quit.
Institutionalized? Look, fucking idiot. Consistency here is key.
A man's gonna have some loyalty, you know? Look how fast he'd sell his fucking wife.
I'd sell his mother.
Okay. Look. Yes, I have a ring, but I don't have a wife, and I can explain why.
Oh, my God. The Roman's gotta hear this shit.
Forget about the Roman. His wife's gotta hear this. I'm sure she'd love to know she doesn't exist. Hang on a second. Where are you? What happened? You fucked up. No, we didn't. He tried to escape. Bloody amateurs. You can't do a simple fucking job. Two men with guns.
Look, just
a fucking
hang on.
Could do it.
We're on our way. We'll be over in 20.
Good. I'll have some professionals work on it.
Listen to this. He says he ain't Julius. He sat right next to me. He says he ain't Julius.
Of course he says he's not Julius. He doesn't want to die.
Listen to me. My name is Greg Newman. You must have confused me with someone else. I'm from Santa Rosa, California.
7 years ago, you were Gary LaRusse from Rhode Island. And 2 years ago, when you swindled $12 million out of the McAlvin Fund, you were Frank J. Coolidge from Albuquerque. Didn't know we were filming the office.
No, I didn't know because I'm not him.
Save it. I was at the airport. I saw you step into taxi 8217. Not very discreet. Your shiny blue suit, your brown leather briefcase. That's how we nailed you, you son of a bitch.
I don't understand.
This guy's phenomenal. He wears a wedding ring and says he ain't got a wife. What a douchebag.
You won't have a wife very soon with this attitude. You hear me, you bastard?
She is not my wife. I don't have a wife.
Julius. I don't know where I am.
I don't know who you are. My name is Greg, and you have to tell them that you don't know me. Listen, lady, I don't know who you are. You have to tell them I am not your husband.
That's not my husband. I want to talk to you.
Okay, Julius, nice try. See you in 20.
Hey, Roman. Thanks,
God.
Greg just looks like this Julius guy. You ever think of that?
Maybe you talk too much.
Please. I swear, I am not your guy.
A con man's gotta keep his wedding vows.
The ring I can explain.
Don't bother.
I'm curious. I want to see what you can come up with.
Waste your time.
I was lying. Before. About the wife.
Oh, you were lying.
He was lying. I don't know, he's throwing me off.
Stop throwing me off.
You were lying about being Greg Newman.
Newman, Greg Newman. No, that is my real name.
Okay, I lost it lying.
I wear a ring for work. I'm a salesman.
Salesman, con man, tomato, tomato.
It's the truth. I sell to churches. You have to put on an act when you sell to churches. They want to work with family men. Christian, church-going, Bible-quoting, married men. But to them, a single guy my age is either gay or a playboy. Or a gay playboy, which is a one-way ticket to hell by some of them. They want to see that wedding ring.
He's making it up as he goes along.
I have to wear the ring. It's an act.
This whole thing is an act.
Okay. What do you sell?
Oh, come on. Give me a break. He sells bullshit.
I'm humoring him.
He's humoring you.
What do you sell?
Holy water.
Holy shit.
It's a real business. It's Genesis holy water from the River Jordan. We bottle it in the Holy Land and then ship it to Kentucky. There's a huge market for it. I do the legwork. I go to churches and I give them the sales pitch.
Okay, let's hear it.
You want to hear the sales pitch?
Like your life depends on it.
Well, I usually set up a meeting.
I don't want to hear how you do it. I want to hear the pitch. Pretend like you're Greg Newman.
Patron saint of liars.
Like you're Greg Newman from Santa Rosa.
I am Greg Newman.
Okay, that's good. See, it's feeling more authentic. It's more convincing.
I'm not feeling it.
Shut up.
All right, look. I'll give you the short sales pitch, but... You know, I change it. It's different if you're Catholic or Baptist or Methodist.
Personal Catholic.
Catholic. Okay. Say salesmanship is 99% perspiration and 1% inspiration. For me, it's the other way around. When it comes to sincere marketing, inspiration to heal lost souls, thirsty souls. You see, they quench their thirst with the wrong substances. They sell supplements for everything today, but they still haven't cured deficiencies of spirit. What folks need is vitamin water of a much greater nature. I submit to you that every Catholic family should have holy water in the home, and it is the role of the church to put it there. Some people say the church has fallen from grace. No, sir. That's a lie. They say there's a crisis of faith. I say there's always been a crisis of faith. There's too many forces working against the side of heaven. Too much heresy is blocking the airwaves. Good people are deeply lost in the realms of the unholy. Forgive them, for they know not what they do. No, sir. That just won't cut it. We can forgive them, but we cannot forgive ourselves for not showing them the way. They go with the flow. We have a different flow to offer, and it is a mighty and holy river. Genesis holy water from the River Jordan. The church should not only endorse it, but sell it. Wholesale. And believers will cross over to our side as those who crossed the River Jordan to hear the Lord preach, and they were healed. When the enemies of the Lord sought to capture him, Jesus took refuge in the River Jordan, where John had first baptized him. When all people were baptized and Jesus was at prayer, the skies opened and the Holy Spirit descended. Luke. Chapter 3, verse 21.
Are you fucking serious?
He knows his lines.
A Bible here to test it?
No.
So then you are the fool who walketh in the darkness. Book of Casper, chapter 3, verse 9.
Well, it sounds pretty good to me.
Of course it sounds good. He's a con artist, and he's brilliant at it. Hats off.
I don't know, man. Nobody talks the talk like that unless they do it for a living.
Con artists do. That's why he managed to steal $4 million from the Roman. You can Jesus me till the holy cows come home. I ain't buying it for a second.
Kinda wanna listen.
No, you don't wanna listen. You wanna believe, because you feel guilty because he's gonna die for his sins.
I just don't want him to die if he ain't Julius.
And Julius knows that, so he's trying to make you believe. I know how this whole thing works. I got a friend. She's a phone sex operator. She can make you believe anything. You want it to be all hot and wet? She's coming. You want to have sex with a Martian? You can feel the little green antennas crawling all over your skin. And she can sell you holy water just like Julius Jackson. And you'll buy it because you're a believer, ain't you?
Everything I said is true.
You want a mock trial?
Okay.
You got it. Let's have a look. Ooh, an apple. Mm-hmm. Where's your holy water, salesman? Where are your samples, your holy Bible, your brochures? Where are they?
I don't have them on me.
Big fucking surprise. If this guy's a holy water salesman, I'm the Pope.
Where's your stuff?
I'm not in town to sell.
No, you're in town because you live in town with Mrs. Jax, whom you'll send to the lions in a heartbeat, you Christian.
If you're from Santa Rosa, why are you flying into town?
I have a meeting with Elmer Jonas. He's a famous TV evangelist. You can look him up.
Yeah, no, I know that guy. It's like on Channel 40 or something, like the Salvation Network.
Take the Oak Valley exit, turn right, and shut the fuck up!
Elmer Jonas, isn't that that guy that said that God has a special place in hell for gay people?
Yes, he's a bigot, but he's also watched by 4 million Americans every Sunday. And he's staying at the Waterfront Plaza.
So you're going for a business meeting without your business materials?
Hmm. Look, I already met him and gave him the full pitch that this is a follow-up.
So, what if you run into his colleagues in that thirsty for your holy word? No samples?
Look, I met him in April. My boss wanted him to endorse our water on his show. I spent the weekend with him.
So what's the meeting for?
I was meeting Elmer about something personal.
Take your time. Think something good.
I had his number in the cell phone that you broke.
Hey, we're getting to the Roman and he doesn't want to hear any bullshit stories, trust me.
It's a personal appointment. I need money.
4 million from the Roman wasn't enough.
Kill me. I probably deserve everything that's coming to me.
You done? Finished? Good? All good? Got it all out? Bravo.
Well done. Come on.
Bravo! What a performance.
Best performance by a liar in a major motion picture. There are con men in this world, and there are con artists, and you, my friend, are Da Vinci. Hey, flip a bitch. We're taking this guy to Hollywood. He's an actor. That guy's an actor.
Sinner.
Finally, the confession.
Talk to me, Greg.
I was on my way to see Elmer. He's rich, he's a millionaire. He's got a show on his ranch down south. He'd invited me to spend the weekend. Look, Elmer is the champion of family values. His wife had gone to visit Children's Hospital that weekend. Just like everybody else. We had a late dinner. When I returned to my room, he put me up as far away from his room as possible, so I couldn't hear.
Hear what?
There were other guests in the house. Another man. We spent the night together.
You're in town to blackmail Elmer Jonas?
No. I just thought that maybe Elmer would give me money. I would never breathe a word about it.
Come on, man. You came to blackmail the guy. Nobody just hands that shit to you.
Yeah, the blackmailer will you give him the millionaire to.
My mother was diagnosed with congestive heart failure. It was a nightmare. We got her the best doctors.
We, as in you and your wife?
We, as in me and my mom, with her money, too. I took her to a private hospital. Private nurses around the clock. I didn't give a damn about the money. They said she'd be out of there in 6 months. It's been 5 years now. It cost me $200,000 a year to keep her alive. People say she's in pain. She's old, just pull the plug. And I know if I pull the plug, I wouldn't be doing it for her. I'd be doing it for me. So I can stop pain. I can stop this nightmare. I will
was well off before. I sold everything. I sold my house. The insurance company found a loophole. They said she lied on the forms. They're not paying a dime. Friends say I should just put her someplace. Someplace where old people go to die. That's the worst sin, to let her go without taking responsibility. Just stop the pain. Stop the pain. Let your mother go. I can't make money fast enough. I'm crumbling.
And you were stealing from this guy.
All the holy water in the world can't help my mother. Can't even pay the bills. I'm a hypocrite. I take that crisis of faith and I put it in an act like I have all the answers. I tried to pray. Nobody answered. And when sin is at the door, yes, I would blackmail a man to keep my mother alive. That means I burn in hell. I don't see a lot of people down there. Insurance companies that kill, bigot preachers that spread hate, and people who drive other people to their death. I hope there is a God without mercy. And I pray. I pray that Judgment Day is coming soon.
There.
Pull over.
Yeah?
Yeah. Get out of the car. I want to talk to you.
We will talk when we get to the Roman.
We're not going to the Roman. Get out of the car.
Hey, you're not the captain of this ship. I'll decide what...
Get out.
Oh, my God. Girl's gonna give me a fucking hurry. Stay here. Damn it. What?
was it now?
Got the wrong guy.
No, we did not. The Roman identified him at the airport.
No, something just doesn't feel right.
Yeah, you know what it is? You're a weak, whiny little kitten that wants to be a lion, but you ain't got the balls to scratch.
I think we're gonna make it. She believes your story.
It's the truth.
I don't give a shit if you're Julius Jack, so if you're in town to blackmail Emma Jonas, it's working.
It's not working. Listen to me, when we get to where they're taking us, they're gonna kill me and they're gonna kill you too. Do you understand? We have to get out of this right now.
Okay, I'm not going anywhere.
There's no way a con man could come up with that shit.
I thought you were naive, but you're just plain stupid. You can walk away from the Roman and get away with it?
Well, fuck the Roman. I never even wanted to work for him. You talked me into it.
Oh, you needed the money, you little sissy.
You're a coward.
Well, I'm a coward. Good. You know what? You run for it. Make a dash. I don't give a shit. I'm staying right here. Sometimes it's best to just wait.
If we wait, we're dead.
Look, he's telling the truth. I thought he was Julius, but he's just some fuck out of luck, and I'm not gonna have his blood on my hands.
What? You afraid of God? If there's judgment coming, it's coming from the Roman, and it's coming fast.
I'm not afraid of him.
I will take you, mate. You can hitchhike back to the fucking city.
I'm not gonna let you take it.
You gonna stop me?
No. You're not gonna stop me.
Now, please. With sugar on top. Get in the fucking car! Now!
This girl is trying to
hey! Hey!
Hey!
Hey!
Hey!
Hey!
Hey! Whoa, 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 whoa! Stop, stop, stop! Dude, just hang on a second.
Just for you,
hang
huh?
on a second!
Huh? Who's bluffing now?
Just wait, I'm working for the Roman! Nothing to do with you! I was working for the Roman. Take a breath, take a breath. Stop, stop, just take a breath.
Drop the gun.
What are you doing? What are you doing?
Drop the fucking gun.
What are you doing? I got him!
I said, drop the fucking gun.
Attaboy.
I was never with you. Never with you. You understand me? Yeah?
I thought you'd be a little smarter than that, Julius. You never trust a cabbie.
That's true. You know, you of all people should know that every great con has a chill.
What, you didn't think for a second that maybe the Roman would have one of his men drive the cab? Huh? Bozo?
For a second, actually, the way you were yelling at me, I thought maybe you didn't know.
You thought I didn't know? Let's get in the cab.
Get the fucking cab. Go, get in the cab.
Get in the cab! Oh! Oh, Billy! 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 Billy!
Oh,
Billy!
Don't
oh, shit! She got shot! You shot her! She's dead.
What do you want to do?
Down! Down! Get down! Get down now!
What do you want to do?
Down.
You want to do it?
No, we're gonna shoot. I'm gonna shoot right now! She wanted to let you go!
Hey, listen to
fucking
me.
Asshole!
You want to get paid?
Fuck.
You want to get paid or you want to fucking waste him? He's a dead man.
Yeah, he's a dead man
bring
right
him
now.
To the Roman, he fucking whacks him. It's all over.
Yeah.
Forget about him. Get him in the cuffs. Get him in the fucking
right,
cab.
Right,
let's get him in the Roman
cuffs,
right now. I'm going to take care of Billy.
Stay there. Son of a bitch. Put your hands around your back. Put your hands around your back. Fuck. Get up. Get up. Get up. Get in the car. Get in the car.
Oh, Jesus.
It's all right. It's all right.
God. Fucking damn it.
Shit. Yeah,
listen,
you're gonna be okay.
Billy.
All right, don't worry about it. It's gonna be fun.
Yeah. Holy shit.
It's gonna be okay.
Yeah.
So make a left here. Right on Sherman Road, I think. You're gonna see a warehouse. It's the last warehouse on the left. Yeah.
Where are you?
We're close. Listen, there was a problem. Billy got shot and she's dead.
Listen carefully. I'm not taking any chances. I want you to bring Julius into the warehouse in handcuffs with guns to his head. If he tries to escape, shoot him. His wife is here. I don't want him going crazy.
Didn't say nothing about Billy. Didn't ask about Billy.
He's an asshole.
He's like a brother to me, you know. Shot in the street was the way to die.
There's no good way to die.
You know,
know, every time I did the millionaire tour, I would tell her how much money I earned. And she was never interested. Not because she was scared, she just didn't want to do it, you know. She's
this one here?
That's the next one.
Next one.
Let the Roman know they're here.
They're here.
And the Roman's really pissed.
Fear no evil, for you are with me.
Shut up.
What is this?
Wife is, do you?
No. I don't know.
You know, it's a real shame. Different time, different place. You and I might have been able to work together.
Wait, just wait. Shh.
Thanks.
All right, let's go.
You're almost dead.
Come here. Come here. Oh my God.
You okay?
Yeah. Two men came into the house last night, and then they asked me where you were, and I said, no, you went out of town, and then they found this email with me, with your flight reservation, and
shh,
I knew you were coming. I thought they were gonna kill you.
Shh.
I'm gonna patch you up when we get home, okay?
You're safe. It's okay.
knows that.
That's Greg Newman. He's a salesman from Santa Rosa.
What is he doing here?
Well, he sort of helped me save you.
Thank you.
Is that Sammy?
No. It's Eddie.
Are you gonna let me go?
Okay, what happened?
I called home last night. Tell you my flight was delayed. You didn't pick up, so I called your cell phone 10 times. Nothing. That's when I knew something happened.
So?
By the time I got to the airport, I realized I was being cased. I thought, probably to Roman, but I wasn't sure. I get outside and then there's this shifty-looking cab driver tries to solicit me for a ride, you know? So I figure, you know what the hell? I'll get in a cab. I'll go for a ride. I get in, this guy's got the AC cranked. I mean, the cab's like an icebox, but he's sweating like a pig. Pulls up alongside these two men, expecting them to jump in. But they don't. They don't know what the hell's going on. They don't even understand. That's when it dawns on me. Better safe than sorry. I grab the cab driver on the neck. Tell him I got a gun on his back.
Put your hands on the wheel. You're not working for the Roman.
No, not at all. What do you want?
I'm telling you to keep your hands on a wheel or you're a dead man. Okay, up here. Go ahead. Make a move. Make a move. Go ahead. Nice and easy. Where's my wife? Where's my wife?
I don't
wife?
Know.
Don't lie to me. If you lie to me, I will kill you.
I don't know, okay? I'm not working for it.
No, no, no.
Two guys are supposed to get in the car. I don't know where they're gonna take you, all right?
God. He swears up and down he doesn't know that the Roman paid him to pick me up and that two guys were gonna jump in the cab and take me for a ride. I asked him how he knew what I looked like. He told me the Roman identified me in the airport. White guy, dark hair, blue suit, brown briefcase.
This spot right here. Park, I'm gonna ask you one last time. Where are they gonna take me?
I don't know.
You don't know?
I don't know!
Where are they gonna take me?
They didn't tell me!
Oh,
they didn't tell me!
So, basically, I learned everything I needed to know from the driver. You know, some cab drivers, they're just always talking, never shut up.
I had to act fast. The Roman had seen me get into the cab, but his two guys hadn't. Now, if I switch places with the cabbie, the Roman's boys would lead me right to you, right? Sure, I mean, it's a long shot, but it was my only chance. And you know what? I got lucky, because eventually I found our boy Greg.
The salesman from Santa Rosa.
Exactly.
Hey, so, where you headed?
Do I have a choice?
Nope. Yep. Let's go.
What are you gonna do about Greg?
We're going for a ride.
No, you can't.
You know that I have to.
Not this time.
You're going soft on me. A little bit. I'll be back in an hour. You know we're all gonna die.
I know. I know.
I'm talking about the situation with your mother.
Could I ask you to do something for me? Did you get a message to my mother? Just tell her that I never lost my faith. Tell her I love her. She was right. And that I never lost my faith.
I think I can do that for you. Greg Newman from Santa Rosa. I was raised by my mother. Raised. Hell, she made me who I am. Just the two of us. Then things turned. I had to cut her loose. See, Greg, we have a lot more in common than just our taste in suits. Say this once, and you need to remember it for the rest of your life. I don't care how you lost your money or your credit cards, how you got those bruises on your face or the blood on your shirt. Casper, Billy, the Roman, you never met them. You never got in a cab. You never went on a millionaire tour. And you most certainly never, ever met anyone named Julius Jax.
Okay.
And I'm finished. I know your name. I know where you live. And I most certainly know what you look like. If cops come knocking on my door looking for Julius Jax, Julius Jax is gonna come looking for you. Do we understand each other?
Yeah.
That's good. Turn around. To your mother, anonymously, of course.
Thank you.
Don't forget your briefcase.
They were hailed as national heroes, but now, 30 years later, they're forced to confront the truth, which could tear their lives apart. Helen Mirren, Tom Wilkinson, and Sam Worthington star in The Debt, now showing on Sky Movies Premier HD. And there are hundreds more movies to watch on demand through a Sky Plus HD box when you connect it to the internet. Find out more at skymovies.com.